Finally, it has arrived. First World Championship F5J, hosted by Trnava at the Boleras airfield, some 10 kilometers out of city of Trnava. All of us have been waiting for this for a long time. Some of us have been working on it for almost 10 years to make this a reality, and now here it is. We're looking at first group of juniors, first start of the day on Monday morning, and weather is hot, will be humid with some chance of storms in the evening and night. And juniors have the honor to open this competition. Today there should be very little wind, similar as we had in the preliminary competition, but tomorrow and Wednesday forecast is much more typical for this place, with gusts up to 10 meters per second. So just before the start there was a bird circling just in front of the start line, and that bird went to the left, which is northeast, and looks like majority of the juniors went over there now. I see just one remained over the runway, and he's also very much higher than the rest of them. So now it becomes a game of who is the lowest and who will make the flight from the lowest height. So as I explained yesterday, with the conditions like this you practically have to be the lowest guy in the group to make the flyoffs. Not much room for safe choices of heights. Maybe additional 5 meters is still okay, but anything more than that will give you enough negative points to put you out of flyoffs. In the windless days the differences will be minimal, so it's even much more critical that you don't make any mistake. And windy days, I'm sure there's where the differences will come from, and those days will make all the difference in the scoring. Much is happening there around those trees. Not enough wind and not enough heat yet. I also hear some engine running. That's totally not cool. Thank you. yeah. Corn is also uncool. One in the corn, one just about to land. So looks like a higher height was a better choice this morning. No chance whatsoever to recognize who's flying which plane at this distance. So best I can do is just follow one and see what's happening with him. Huh. One more landing. And one more.
Number 7, Colorado. Number 8, Chris. Number 9, Nikita Pavlov. Number 10, Nikola Sasa. Number 11, Yaroslav Orzel Junior. Number 12, Ivan Tushko. Ready box group number 2.
So looks like this. Early morning start will make more difference than I expected. And I see people walking there. Retrieve the planes from behind the tree line. Well, at least the field there is already harvested, so it should be easy. Now the question is, who is still flying? One more plane over there. Looks like corn cooled down overnight considerably and is just sucking air down now. He lost lots of height just covering that distance over the cornfield. And didn't even make it to the point. Anyone else flying? don't see anyone else and didn't count the planes. So let's see if anyone is still holding to the radio. Maybe that guy? No? I think no one did the full time. Amazing. Totally didn't expect that. Seems like everyone is really competitive and eager to get the maximum score, and they all launched too low. An interesting development. Now this will be their drop score and they will have to fly much more cautiously. Let's see now what the second group of juniors will do. I assume they got a lesson from the first one and they will all start higher. So they're both going higher and to the other side, so to my right, towards the west. There's only one who went to the northeast again. But he's much higher, about 160 I would say. So now the game is on, let's see what the guys here will do. Breeze up the runway from the town, so if there's anything happening in the air, I guess it's happening behind me. Another option is there over the tree line behind the camp, and this guy looks like it's making good use of that. From here it looked like he's in good air, but apparently he wasn't satisfied with it. So he's now looking for another thermal. Now returning the same way he came to here, so that's what I noticed, this bump. I think he's a bit in front of it. Looks like now he will make a minute or so there over the runway and then land. In the meantime, there over the tree line, there's one guy still high, all alone, flying solo, relaxed, and looks good for now. Then there are some planes high above the runway. High above the camp. There's one more landing right now. And there's now another one, relatively low, trying to get something out of the camp and the trees there. Now the wind is picking up, but it's blowing into my right, so towards the cornfield to my left. Interesting. But I guess that's good news for that guy as well, because behind those trees and behind the camp there's a slope down into the valley. So if this wind is also same direction over there, it could be good news for him. Let's see if he makes it. Looking good so far. I think he moved up the runway now a bit. He's looking for a good air to do the remaining 3 minutes or so. Height. Two minutes to go and doesn't look like he'll make it. Now full of noises, but the planes that did manage to gain enough height and they have to lose this height now to land. Hier. Definitely not. He was 6 seconds early. And looks like way off the dot. Okay, looks like the thermals are now starting to heat up, air starting to move, and I'll take a break and go into the shade and then maybe do a few rounds of senior flights, then a few more in the afternoon. This is now start of the first senior group. I think the air has warmed up now, and let's see what they will do. They're now starting towards me because there's air blowing in my back, and they're turning towards the camp already. Nicely spread out. Three behind me, three to my right, and just one to my left over the corn. So majority of the planes are here. No idea whom to follow. Let's take this one. Two planes relatively close over the parking area. We had lots of discussion about this yesterday at the team manager meeting. What is 6 meters over the camp and 3 meters over the starting corridor as a safety area, how to measure that. And as a result now, I think they set up some poles. Here's one for example. And they should be 6 meters high. There's the other one. So if the anyone from the jury sitting at the container there sees any plane flying in a visual line below that pole, they will apply penalty. Yeah, looks like the air has warmed up now considerably. All of the planes here are now much higher already. So the only one struggling now is the one who went over the corn and is now doing a solo over there. I think he'll also make it. There was a noise, a bump, and I see a piece falling from the sky. Whatever that is, piece of tail or a wingtip or something, or a canopy maybe. Doesn't look like any of the planes is really affected. But now that piece is climbing, that's always very interesting to see. Not sure if I can get it on camera. No idea what this is. But it's going up and down all over the place. So yeah, pilots can now use that piece as a marker of where the thermal is. Very funny. Looks like they didn't opt for a refly. Which makes sense, since all of the planes still look very controllable. So let's return to the lowest plane here over the runway. Let's get some ground in for reference. Looks like he gained a bit of height coming from the other side of the field, which tells me sooner or later he will also join the flock and make the full time easily. So I guess his only loss is that he was much higher in the start, and the rest of the group started at 1/3 of his height, I would say. So that piece is now landing somewhere over there. Landed somewhere behind that umbrella, or at least in that direction behind the umbrella. Looks like someone is already going to retrieve it. So it's not lost, that's good. And now all the planes are high enough and there's basically nothing for me to see anymore. So see you in the next round. It's now almost 5 p.m. afternoon of the first day. We are now at round 3, group 2 of the senior flights qualifying rounds. We still have barely any wind. Every now and then there is a gust driven by thermals. And we have the first signs of storm clouds in the distance that will come to us in the evening and night. Let's see how flying is done now. Low and slow, so looks like the air is hot enough. And someone already shut off their motor at the corridor, but the majority is over here, over the hangars. And there's one plane to my right going for the red hangar. Not sure, but could be the lowest one. So let's check him. doesn't look too convinced about the quality of the air here and is moving to join the rest of the flock. Even the one that started over the corridor is now moving slowly to the apron. He's not yet at the hangars, but he's also climbing slowly but steadily. It doesn't look like anyone has some challenges ahead of him. From what I can see, all are climbing. So this guy started over the corridor and is now joining the flock here. Let's see if he will manage to get a connection to this thermal. Looks like there's nothing for him. But I don't know what plane that is. It looks very interesting with very low dihedral on the wing. Look like someone started only now. Don't know why, could be some technical problem. But the guy that started late flew back to the hangar and is definitely in much better air. Not sure why this guy is determined to stay where he is. But looks like even he now got something. Looks like he has something, and the other guy is kind of giving up. Or at least he lost half of what he got. And is now trying a different place. Now he got something just as he was preparing to land. That feels like someone sent you a thermal just on the last second. Let's see if it holds. He still has to do almost 2 minutes. The right turn, he should have stayed there. Not sure why he made a left turn. And the rest of the flock is coming down now. One minute to go, that's what it's time to do. And landing in last second. Cool. This is a good result for this guy.